Well, hello, hello, hello. Look, quick pop up. Look, quick pop up. Look, quick pop up. Word of encouragement that I want to give you, speak to you in this wise today. And actually, I was requested to come back and do some more encouraging, do some more talking. And so I'm back and I'm talking and I'm encouraging. Welcome, 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 welcome. Just a few minutes, a word of encouragement. I just want to encourage you for a few minutes. And the word, if I want to use a word, the word that I will use to you today is that God want you as believers, as those who's waiting on God for a miracle, who's waiting on God for a breakthrough. God want to make sure that there's nothing in the way of receiving what God has for you today. Many of you, you're praying and you're believing for healing. You're believing for increase. You're believing that more unity come in your family. You're believing that God touch your family, touch your kids, that your kids and your relationship with your kids become even better. Healing in your body. You pray that your body becomes strong again like it once again. There's some of you that are praying that God even impregnate you and that you might even have a child. What are those, all those things? God is delivering and God is healing and God is granting those petitions. But the thing that God want to caution you, and I want to caution you on, to make sure that there's no idols in your way between you and God. No idols or no images. And what is an idol or what is an image? An idol or an image is something that you reference to when you're in a time of trouble, that you reference to instead of God, something that you pay attention to all the time, something that you give all your time to, just like a job, or just like money, just like television, just like your body, just like an addiction, whatever it is, it's an image. An addiction is an image. It's an image. And see, God wants to remove you, to remove all those images. See, some of you, when you're in trouble, and when you're in desperate situations, instead of going to God for help and asking God to give you strength, you will turn to food. See, some of you, your God and your image is your food. And God says you will not have no God or image before him. And so the reason why I'm saying this is because, see, many of you that listen to me, your blessing will be held up. Your blessing will not come if you're holding on to certain things that you know within your own spirit that God is telling you to let go of. There are certain appetites. There are certain things that there are certain pathways. See, some of you might say, well, I don't see it. See, that's the problem. You don't see it. See, because the Bible says there's a way that seemeth right unto man, but the end of that way is death. It's not about your eyes. It's not about your feeling, but it's about what God's word has said. And so if you want to be blessed and if you want to receive what God has for you seriously, you must remove and let go of certain things. This is why even the Bible said, Jesus said, if any man come after me, in other words, accept him, he must take up his cross and follow me, deny his flesh. In other words, you must give up something. You must let go of something. You must release something. Something is between you and God from hearing and receiving God. Something has your focus. Until God has your complete focus, then God cannot and will not bless you completely. And so all I'm saying is to let go and remove certain things. God has given you the strength. You might say, well, I'm not strong enough. I don't have the strength. I'm not powerful enough. You're powerful. You're powerful. God has given you the grace. What is grace? Grace is ability. Ability. Ability is strength. All you got to do is open up your mouth. Any addiction, anything that you need God to heal you from, anything you need God to help you with, all you got to do is open up your mouth and say, God, help me. My condition, my situation, your breakthrough and your deliverance is in your mouth. Just say, God, help me. And you ain't got to pray a cute prayer. Just say, God, help me. I need help. God, help me. Help my mind. God, help my addiction. Help my anger. Help my manipulation. Help my wandering eyes. Whatever it is that you need help, just cry out to him. That's a prayer in itself. Just send help. That's a prayer. You ain't got to pray cute. Just say, God, I'm in a situation. God, I'm in a predicament and I need you. God, I need you to help me. God, I need you to save me from myself.
Some of you, you need to be saved from yourself. You got an addiction where you need to be delivered from it, but you find yourself, you can't get free from it. You need God. This thing, God can only be the one that can deliver you. Just cry out to him. Just say, God, help me. Simply. The Bible said, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord, they shall be saved, delivered. In other words, also, God can rescue you. God can take that thing away from you. God can bring that thing out of you. God can heal you from that situation. God can heal you from that pain. God can heal you from that predicament. But it starts with you. It starts from you making a choice. I decide. I choose to be free. You choose to. If you're bound, you choose to be bound. You don't have to accept bondage. You don't have to accept bondage. Yeah, there's a feeling. Yeah, in your bondage, you might feel good. In that bondage, it might feel good. It might feel good. See, but that feeling ain't going to last always. Even in a breakup, some of you done been through a bad breakup, and you think the breakup is it's death, it's the end of life. The breakup that you just went through, it's God, and because of the breakup, now God's gonna cause other things to open up for you. God's gonna cause other doors to open up for you. See, God had to allow this thing to happen in order to bless you. See, you've been moping and you've been sad, and discouraged, and worried. But God is saying you're blessed. And not many days hence from this, once the pain subsides, your blessing, your pain is your blessing. What you think was bad is good. It's a good thing. I got to go. Got to get ready to go to work. But just want to come on today, encourage you, be encouraged. Stay the course. Keep trusting God. Keep holding your mouth right. Keep believing in God. It's going to happen to remove that thing. Let it go. Let go of it. Trust God. Believe him. Remove that image. Remove that statue. Remove that curse. Remove all those things that you praise. Remove all those things that you worship. Worship belongs to God. Praise belongs to God. Glory belongs to God. Not a man. Not a situation. Get rid of that thing and let God live. Have a good day. God bless you.